we are back live on Monday Night Raw with the phenomenal AJ Styles of the OC.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the best tag team in the world, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson, and the phenomenal AJ Styles, the OC!
Disappointing would be an understatement for what happened last night at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view as AJ Styles found himself on the wrong end of not just Aleister Black, but the dead man, The Undertaker.
If you can run your mouth and disparage the dead man one too many times, and AJ Styles paid the price for doing so.
And King, a repeat for AJ Styles of the altercation he had at Super Showdown 2 weeks ago when The Undertaker came to the aid that night of Rey Mysterio and took out Styles.
Yeah, I'm sure we're going to hear a few choice words about The Undertaker now. He's upset, you can tell.
Not once, but twice, The Undertaker has stuck his nose in my business where it doesn't belong. Not once, but twice, The Undertaker has taken moments from me. He stole a beautiful trophy from me at Super Showdown. And then last night at Elimination Chamber, he cost me a match. Check this out.
Now, last night it was a no disqualification. This is a no disqualification match of AJ Styles versus Aleister Black.
Styles ultra confident in this match because he knows he's got assistance waiting for him.
And here comes Gallows. Anderson into the play.
Aleister Black daring the entire OC.
Down by the OC.
I don't know if Aleister Black can overcome this. I think Styles is ready to finish off Aleister Black.
Oh my God! He's here! The Undertaker!
Where did he come from?
The Phenom! Chokeslam to Styles!
Undertaker's gone,
but this no disqualification match still ongoing. Black Mass! Aleister Black has beaten AJ Styles! The Undertaker making his presence felt right in the face of the Phenomenal One!
Ago at WrestleMania, I saw The Undertaker get beat by Roman Reigns. And after the match, The Undertaker folded his jacket, took off his gloves and his hat, and laid them nice and neat right in the middle of the ring. I watched him walk up the aisle, and halfway up, he threw his fist up as if he were riding off into the sunset. Truthfully, I think that he probably should have done that when Brock Lesnar ended his streak, but whatever, it doesn't matter. The point is, it was a beautiful, powerful moment, and The Undertaker ruined it. He ruined it when he came back to the WWE. What was it, Taker? Was it your ego? What was it, the spotlight? Whatever it is, it's going to cost you. because I want you at WrestleMania. Hey, hey, hey. 10 years ago, I'd maybe have been a little bit hesitant about calling The Undertaker out. But the truth is, I don't see this mythical monster anymore. I don't see this phenom anymore. What I do see is a broken down old man named Mark Calloway. Undertaker should have retired 10 years ago when he was in his prime. I don't know what keeps him coming back, but I've got a pretty good idea. It's his wife. It's Michelle. It's Michelle McCool. Hey, Michelle, I hope you're watching at home because I'm about to let the cat out of the bag here. Michelle McCool and The Undertaker are married, if you didn't know. Hey, and she plays him like a fiddle. Anything and everything she wants, she gets, despite her husband walking down the aisle, getting in this ring, and getting hurt every time he steps in it now. Hey. They got a beautiful, beautiful family. Everything's great. She's just the most conniving person I have ever met in my entire life. You can boo all you want. The truth is the truth. So, hey, how about this? How about I give The Undertaker a little advice? I'm a good guy. Undertaker. Your wife is gonna run you into the ground. And I'm gonna help her. I'm gonna make sure you die in that ring at WrestleMania. How about this? Let me rephrase it. I'm gonna take The Undertaker's soul at WrestleMania. I'm gonna do exactly what his wife wants me to do. It's pretty simple. I'm challenging The Undertaker to a one-on-one match at WrestleMania. I mean, come on, Taker. What do you got to lose? You've already lost your dignity, your pride, your mystique. Like I said, you're just a broken down old man. Oh, boo all you want, cheer all you want, yell for The Undertaker all you want. Here's the truth. Taker, I hope you're listening. These people, they don't give a damn about you. So accept my challenge, Taker, and fight me at WrestleMania, and I promise you, I will literally put the nail in your coffin.
AJ Styles just made this very personal.
AJ said he called it letting the cat out of the bag. I call it crossing a line that you shouldn't cross.
If you want to make an impact in WWE, you go after the biggest and baddest, you make it personal. But did AJ Styles just make a critical mistake? Styles wants The Undertaker at WrestleMania.